হরে কৃষ্ণ মদন মোহন হরি বলে আমার ভাবামে যতক্ষণ নইলে মদন শুধু নইলে শুধু বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ গিরিধরে ছিল শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধা শক্তি সঞ্চারিল রইলে পারবে কেন কৃষ্ণ কৃষ্ণ নইলে পারবে কেন শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণের মাথায় ময়ূর পাখা শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণের মাথায় ময়ূর পাখা শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধার নাম গীতাতে লেখা বলে আমার কৃষ্ণের জুড়া বামে হেলে শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণের জুড়া বামে হেলে শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধার চরণ পাবে বলে শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধার চরণ পাবে বলে চূড়া তাইতো বামে হেলে চূড়া তাইতো বামে হেলে শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগৎ শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগৎ আর জীবন শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগৎ আর জীবন শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধা জীবনের জীবন শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধা জীবনের জীবন নইলে শূন্য জীবন শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগৎ চিন্তামণি শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধা প্রেম শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধা প্রেম তো কৃষ্ণে জানি তোমার কৃষ্ণে জানি সে যে তোমার কৃষ্ণে জানি শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণের বাসি করে গান শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণের বাসি করে গান সত্যি বলে সত্য বটে বলে রাধার নাম শাড়ি বলে সত্য বটে বলে রাধার নাম নইলে মিথ্যায় গান শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগতের গুরু শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধা পঞ্চকল্প করু নইলে টিকার হয় গুরু নইলে শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ প্রেমের অভিখারী শাড়ি বলে আমার রাধা লহরি লহরি কৃষ্ণ প্রেমের ঢেউ কিশোরী, প্রেমের ঢেউ কিশোরী, শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণের কদম তলায় থানা, সারি বলে আমার রাধা করে আনা গোনা, নইলে কৃষ্ণ যেত না, শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগতের কালো, সারি বলে আমার রাধা রূপে জগৎ আলো, নইলে রাধার কালো, শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ চিরাধিকা দাসী, শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ চিরাধিকা দাসী, সারি বলে সত্য বটে সাক্ষী আছে বাসী, নইলে হত কাশী বাসী কৃষ্ণ, শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগত জীবন, সারি বলে আমার রাধা মধুর পবন, নইলে কি করে জীবন, শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগতের প্রাণ, সারি বলে আমার রাধা জীবন করে দান, নইলে বাসে কি প্রাণ, শুভ বলে আমার কৃষ্ণ জগতের প্রাণ, সারি বলে আমার রাধা জীবন করে দান, নইলে বাসে কি যে প্রাণ, শুভ সারি দুজনের দম্ব গুছে গেল, শুভ সারি দুজনের দম্ব গুছে গেল, রাধা কৃষ্ণ হরি বলে বৃন্দাবনে চল,
হম লোক যা পর উপস্থিত হুয়ে হ্যাঁ ব্রজ কে প্রমুখ বনো বারহ বনো মে সে প্রধান বনো মে সে এক তাল বন হ্যাঁ ফ্রেন্ড ইউ হ্যাভ কম দিস ইজ অ্যামং দি প্রমিনেন্ট 12 বনস ফরেস্ট অফ বৃন্দাবন এন্ড ইনক্লুডিং দিস ইন দিস বন দেয়ার আর সো মেনি শাখা অফ বন দেয়ার আর 12 প্রমিনেন্ট forest in Vrindavan. In, they have been also divided in so many Shakhavan. about 12. And there are also 12 upavan. One upavan and shakhavan. Mainly they are 36. But in whole Brajmandal, I think the more than thousands forests are here. So among them, this is also a prominent one. Here Baldev Prabhu killed Dhenukasur. यहाँ पर बलदेव प्रभु जी ने धेनुकासुर का गधे को वध कर और अपने सखाओं को फल चखाया था. इसके संबंध में ये कहा जाता है कि बलदेव प्रभु जी गुरु तत्व हैं. गुरु अज्ञानता को दूर करता है. इस विषय को हम लोग पूज्य पात्र विक्रम महाराज से अनुरोध करेंगे. इसके संबंध में हमें कुछ धाम के संबंध में और उसके शिक्षा के संबंध में हमें कुछ बतलाएं, अंग्रेजी में भी और बंगला में भी.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. आई एम गेटिंग ए चांस टू प्लीज यू. But real pleasure is not possible. Honey is kept in the bottle. Bees are trying to taste it from outside. Is it possible? Never. But bees cannot open this jar. So you should surrender. So you should surrender to the Divine Master first.
We
have
surrendered.
So if we are sincerely surrendered to him, they will get the chance. Thank you. This is the place of Mahasi of Sri Baladev. And also the place of ignorance. As we see in the behavior of Dhenukasur and his family. The ignorance is removed, destroyed by the mercy of Baladev. So this is the place of pastime between Baladev and the ignorance. Devotee cannot enter the spiritual realm, without this mercy of Baladev. Baladev is the main source of Guru Tattva. By his mercy, we can proceed to that realm, the spiritual sphere. Dhenukasur was appointed to guard the garden of Kansa, which was full of tall palm trees. He and his family used to taste them, but none could not be able to taste them. But Krishna and his consort, cowherd boys, wanted to taste the palm fruit. So they requested Baladev, how we shall be able to taste it? Please arrange for that. Baladev then told, yes, no harm, let us go. He came to the garden and take one plant by his force, and the palms fell down. And there was great sound of the falling, so the Dhenukasur rushed to them. Who is he that trying to take the course from the plan, Varsha Baladev and other cow artwell. Then he wished to attack them, but not by front side. He attacked them by their behind legs, with behind legs, throw legs to them. And Baladev, this is the ignorance of ours. This is the ignorance of us. We always bite from backside, not from front. Baladev took hold of the leg and give some round with the dhanukasura in hand and threw it towards the palm tree. Then the palm tree fell down and it fell on the other branch. So the other branch also fell down. Thus all the plant palm tree fell down, and the boy then tried to enjoy the palm fruit. But the fruits became bloody because blood came out from Dhanukasura and his relative who also tried to save him, but was put to death by Baladev. Accordingly, the fruits were not stable, they became very impure, and they left the fruit. Baladev thus killed the Dhanukasura, and the Baladev and such is the fact, though it is outward fact, but the main fact is, so long we possess ignorance, we cannot enter the pastime of Radha Krishna or Baladev or the image of Krishna. By the mercy of Gurudev, who is the incarnation of Baladev, we can destroy our ignorance, we can possess the true knowledge of the Dham or the Tattva, and then we will be able to understand the true situation of Rasa. Betitto bhavana bhatpa jaschamatkar bharabhu riti sattva jali bharam sadati sa rasa bhavata. It is not mental speculation. Betitto bhavana bhatpa. Mind is material, but the pastime cannot be understood by that mind. Prakita bhushtina hai prakita bhushar. Every pastime must be understood when we will acquire the knowledge of transcendental. So long we do not acquire the transcendental knowledge, we cannot understand, we cannot taste any pastime of Radha and Krishna. So we pray here that Baladev may be graced upon us and bless us with the knowledge, so that we may enter to taste the pastime of Radha. Thank
you. अब इस समय तो चारों तरफ में पानी ही पानी में, जहाँ पर आचमन करेंगे वो बल भाग के कुंड हो जाएगा। तो उसी के पास में जो पेड़ दिख रहा है वहीं पर कुमुद वन है, और उसी कुमुद वन में कृष्ण सखाओं के साथ में वहाँ पर कुमुद फूल से माला गूंथते, गोपियाँ गूंथती या सखा लोग गूंथते और परस्पर परस्पर को पहनाते और बहुत सी क्रीड़ाएं करते। उस कुमुद वन की लिए हम यहीं से प्रणाम करते, बोलो कुमुद वन की। यहाँ पर का धाम महात्मा अंग्रेजी में भी, हिंदी में भी, बंगला में भी, सब विषय में हुआ, अब अधिक बोलने की जरूरत नहीं है। सो वंदे प्रभु इज सो मर्सीफुल, ही हैज अरेंज्ड हियर So quickly he is sending something and we will try to list those and you should take and after that we will go again to Madhuban. Gau Brahmanande. Second line.
So in one sense, Guru Dev has to make a pot to get through.
বলুন রুটি কে দোনা করে রে রুটি কে দোনা
দাদা তরকারিটা আনছে না
দিছি ভাই কেন দেব
না দাও সবাইকে দাও
না না দেব আমি
পাবেন কৃষ্ণ হতে গেলে কাম করছে
All right.
বন্ধন ছাড়িব সংসার গো
জান্নবী ও ভয় কোলে
দে সল প্রসাম জানবি ও ভয়ে ভ্রমিতে ভ্রমিতে প্রভু ভাগ ফলে ভ্রমিতে
ভ্রমিতে প্রভু ভাগ ফলে
ভ্রমিতে ভ্রমিতে প্রভু ভাগ ফলে
ভ্রমিতে প্রভু ভাগ ফলে
দেখি কিছু তরু And I will know that Vrindavan Dham and no Deep Dham are same. He is telling those who are Navadvip Dham that a friend in the guidance of a qualified Vaishnava, Rasik Vaishnava. Here and there, in this side and this, that side of Ganges, in Navadvip, I will go here and there, weeping bitterly, heart melting. When the day will come? And when I will have a putti cottage in Navadvip. And anyhow, one day I will see
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or on her conjugal. And then I will be sent. And then I will be in what? Sense again. I will weep bitterly alone here. This is the symptom of coming to Vrindavan. He's praying that when I will come to Vrindavan in the guidance of any very high class of Vaishnava. And I will go through all dense forests of Vrindavan in the guidance of such a qualified person. I'll give up my all worldly desires, everything, honors and offenses, everything. And I will bitter weep here. At once I will say, oh, conjugal Krishna. And then I will do that. May a day come, his name, this is Vrindavan, in this Vrindavan. This is Madhuban. Ye Madhuban hai. Madhuban mein hum log aaye hue hain. Bade shobhagyavan hai. Madhu mane Krishna ka prem ka madhu. Iske sambandh mein Pujya Patra Vikram Maharaj ji aur sab log bhakta batlayenge. Hum piche se jab bhi hoga to kuch bolenge. Abhi Pujya Patra Vikram Maharaj ji is dham ke sambandh mein aapke samne kuch bolenge.
ब्रह्म वस्तु और भगवत वस्तु जो हो इस रस इज द नेक्टर दैट नेक्टर इज द बेस्ट बेस्ट थिंग अबाउट by tasting which we will be fully satisfied. The tasting of that rose is our end. Krishna is the rose. And that rose is tasted by the devotee. Whether they may be in the form of ladies or friends or servants also. But that rose is not material rose. We cannot understand what is that rose. We have idea. We have knowledge of material things. But which is transcendental, we have got no knowledge of it. So, in spite of our attempt to taste the rasa, it is not at all possible this day, in this day, to taste it. But our ultimate goal is there. We must have that taste. That is, we must serve the Lord Krishna in various manners. Dasya Sukha Vatsala Madhur. These are the tasting difference. How it will be possible for us to taste that rose? We are striving to taste that rose, but that rose is transcendental, so we are not unable to taste it. Only by the grace of Lord and His pure devotee, we may give up the habit of enjoyment, seeing material, having material things. And after that, we may be connected. We are transcendental service and gradually proceed to the final goal. This is Madhuvan, the place of tasting that nectar. Krishna left Vrindavan. Gopis, as our knowledge, according to our knowledge, material, are very unhappy. They are always weeping and feeling very sorry. But it is not the fact at all. There is no sorry in the service of Lord. They are the greatest happy devotee of Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna willfully does not appear before them, or in spite of his appearance before them, they do not think that he has appeared by their side or in front. Even lying on the keeping head on his body, Radharani is weeping. Krishna has left us. We are very sorry. What is that? In every sense, in every part of their body, Krishna is always present. In spite of that, that is a kind of separation, which is the best taste of the nectar. Krishna does not leave Vrindavan for a single moment. All is present. He is not present everywhere except Vrindavan. And there is no separation between the devotees, your devotees, or lady devotees, etc. So, in spite of that, they are feeling that sort of separation. This is a kind of joy, transcendental joy, a taste of transcendental happiness. This is the best. Virahatmak jo bhav hai, jo sabse unchi bhav hai. And it was bestowed on Radharani and other best sakhis. They are always unhappy in feeling that Krishna is in meeting the delight is not so great as in separation meeting is very strongly enjoyed. So this sort of thing is unconceivable in this bondage situation. For this reason it is said, get oneself, when oneself will be freed from Maya and entered into the kingdom of Bhav, then he will gradually proceed and occupy that situation. So let us try according to our ability and according to the mercy of our Divine Master upon us, by which we may arrive at the final goal.
शुभानंद ब्रह्मचारी बंगला में यहाँ के
হে বালক ধ্রুব, তুমি সেই কমল লোচন হরির আরাধনা করো। যিনি তোমার পূর্বজগণকে সকলকে অতুল সম্পদা ভোগ বৈভব এবং সংসার থেকে পার করে ভগবান সেই অভয় পাদ পদ্ম দিয়েছেন, ভগবত গতি তাহারা লাভ করেছে। অতএব সেই কমলোচন হরির তুমি আরাধনা করো, নিশ্চয়ই তিনি তোমায় কৃপা করো। সেই মায়ের আদেশে আজ্ঞা পেয়ে ধ্রুব এখন বনের মধ্যে বেরিয়ে চলে আসেন। গভীর বন, চারদিকে বাঘ ভালুক পশু পাখি, সেই বনের মধ্যে কমলোচন হরি কথায় বলতে বলতে তিনি যমুনার ধারে ধারে ভ্রমণ করছেন। এমন সময় ভগবান শ্রীহরি নারদকে বললেন, নারদ আমার এই প্রিয় ভক্ত আমার অন্বেষণের জন্য বেরিয়েছে, সে যে আমাকে পাওয়ার জন্য উৎকণ্ঠিত লালায়ে, তুমি তাহাকে মার্গদর্শন করাও। ভগবান তিনি অন্তর্যামী গুরু হৃদয় মধ্যে অবস্থান করেন, তাই তিনি প্রেরণা দিলেন নারদকে। নারদ ঋষি আসলেন, বললেন, বালক তুমি এস্থানে কি করছো? এই একাকী বনের মধ্যে তুমি বাড়ি ফিরে যাও, এখানে বনের মধ্যে থাকতে নাই, বাঘ ভালো পশু পাখি আছে।
But you should know it is glorious from Satyayuga. He has told, narrated all the stories which took place here. In the Satyayuga, Dhruva Maharaj did astrologies here and he got boon from Narayana. After that, in the time of Ramchandra in Treta Yuga, Ramchandra ordered Satyapurna and he killed Lavanasur here and established Madhupur, and that Madhupuri became Mathura. After that, you know Ambarish Maharaj. Ambarish Maharaj in Dwadashi, he did his mercy to Durvasa Rishi. It was shown that even a king, householder, he is so much superior than a Brahmarshi who can give abhishap, cause that you should at once die or use, and for dead person he will tell, oh, at once God, then he will have life. But even he is nothing in front of Bhaksa, whether he is householder or chanting her name, and he was doing Dwadasi. He did not know the glorification of Bhakti, but by the grace of Ambarish Maharaj he knew this, and he became thoroughly pure Bhakta. Also in Dwapar Yuga, Krishna used to come with his cowherd boy with cows to raise cows and taking madhu, honey from. They will explain all these things there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu and Navdaita Acharya are all acharyas. Even my Gurudev, we have come to become Maharaj, Pujyapad, Bhavan Maharaj with Gurudev so many times here, in tents here, in walking, not in buses. I want that we should come anytime on foot doing parikrama, though it is very hard for Western devotees. You should know that this place is for austerities. Now it is so hot, sadhu or nothing. In hot days, in rainy days, in any days, taking nothing, even air he gave up, water gave up, anything. And he was totally absorbed in austerities, reminding Krishna. We have taken so much breakfast in there, talva. And we are not coming in food, we are coming in buses, doing kirtan. But yet we are so much suffering, tired, feeling so much hot. How you can do austerities like this? So I think that it will be better to return just now Vrindavan, but very nearer to buses here. You can go to see the astrologic place of Dhruva. Dhruva Tilla. Aap log jayenge, aur jo nahi ja sake, or wheelchair, he should not go there. Or the persons who are soft and very delicate, they should be in buses, and all the devotees should quickly go there and return, because the history of that place has been told here. So go and take darshan and take the feet dust of that place and return to your buses and just come to Vrindavan, and in the evening class it will explain everything so elaborately. Go Prama.
Krishna, 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 Hari, Hari, Hari Ram, Hari Ram, 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 Hari, 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 Hari,
theory. Nandanam, namami nandanam, nandanam, namami nandanam, namami nandanam, nandanam, namami Thank you.
Oh, पारमार्थिक श्रद्धा, उसका बाहरी सिम्टम क्या है? उसका बाहरी सिम्टम यह है, हरि गुरु और वैष्णव के वाक्यों पर उसको दृढ़ विश्वास हो जाता है। व्हाट श्रुति आर टेलिंग, व्हाट शुद्ध वैष्णव आर टेलिंग, व्हाट माय गुरु गुरु आर वैष्णव, एट दैट टाइम नो गुरु, उसमें गुरु तो होता नहीं किंतु वैष्णव का संयोग होता है। तो उस समय उनके भक्ति, उस समय जो उसको श्रद्धा हुई, इसके तीन बाहरी लक्षण है। क्या भगवान ने गीता में, भागवत में, श्रुतियों में जो कुछ कहा है और उनके एकांतिक वैष्णव जो कुछ कह रहे हैं, उस पर उनकी ऐसा विश्वास होता है ये बात ठीक है, भले ही वो पालन नहीं कर सकता है दूसरी बात, किंतु बहुत दृढ़ विश्वास होता है। विशेष करके सुखी बात नहीं करते। उस समय में चेष्टा करता है, पालन नहीं करता, दुर्बलताएं बहुत रहती हैं, किंतु ये समझ लेता है कि कृष्ण भक्ति के बिना हमारा जीवन कभी भी उत्पन्न हुई तो मैं कैसे कृष्ण की सेवा लाभ करूँगा। इसके लिए वैष्णव का विशेष रूप से संग करता है और पूर्व जन्मी का संस्कार हो और इधर जिस जन्म का संस्कार आत्माओं का संबंध है तो वो श्रद्धा और प्रदीपिंग इन गोकुल परफॉर्मिंग इन पास टाइम इन गोकुल यशोदा मदर यशोदा इज रनिंग आफ्टर हिम एंड ही इज रनिंग वेरी लिटिल बॉय चाइल्ड नेकेड एंड सो ब्यूटीफुल how much then Sanatan Goswami is here referring one verse from Srimad Bhagavatam and the purpose of this verse it says when Krishna played over the flute at that time all the gopis they came running to Krishna they gave up their all activities whatever activities they were performing they stopped someone was cooking at their kitchen they stopped their cooking someone was serving to their husband they stopped someone was dressing themselves they dressed in irregular manner and they ran away someone was decorating themselves they put the one earring on their ear and then they ran away. Similarly, they could not check themselves. From whatever activity they were doing, they stopped it and then ran away. Krishna, when they came, said, oh, you are very fortunate to have come here. Yeah, I think you have come to see Vrindavan. It's so beautiful. Well, now you must have seen it. You should go back to your house. Because your husbands are waiting for you. It is a religious duty of a woman to serve her husband. May her husband be lame, sick, diseased, and poor. But a chaste wife's duty is that she should always serve her husband. This is very important instruction of the religion, Vedic religion. Now it was turn of gopis. Maharaj said, there are three reasons. Gopis said, number one, O Krishna, you have given us such a nice and wonderful instruction. So that we should follow it and should advance our life, you are our Gurudev. Your instructions are according to scriptures and the scripture says that whenever you are going and perform any religious activity, first you have to worship your Gurudev. And you have given this instruction to us, so you are our Gurudev. So first we will serve to our Guru and then we will do anything else. So if we don't serve you, we will violate the scriptures injunctions. So let us first serve you. Then, second reason, Maharaj is saying, we don't believe it, but you say sometimes and boast, I am Lord, I am God, I have given the Bhagavad Gita lecture to Arjun. In that lecture you say that you have said, ye yathama prapadyante, all those who surrender to me, to whatever proportion and extent they surrender to you, you reciprocate them accordingly. So, now it is your duty. We are going to surrender to you. As per your statement, as you have already said that you are God and you have said this thing, so it is now your duty to fulfill your statement. We are going to surrender ourselves totally to you. You have to reciprocate accordingly. Third, here is the real essence of what
Rupa Goswami is saying in that verse. We are innocent young girls, very, very soft-hearted girls. We have natural tendency to get attracted towards beauty, towards
sweet songs.
We have a natural tendency. Now, you have revealed your such a wonderful beauty, such a sweet beauty to on this earth that no one can resist himself. In all the whole universe, which is comprised of three worlds, no one is there. What to speak of ladies? All the living entities have got a natural tendency to get attracted towards your beauty. This beauty which you have revealed in this breath. When you play your flute, you know, every living entity, not only living entity, even inert things, they give up their intrinsic characteristic. They reverse their nature, like flow of Yamuna stars and its stars flowing other way. Maharaj is explaining here, one by one, that Pakshi, birds, they stop singing and they become silent. Mrug, deer, they give up their nature of fearful nature and they come close to Krishna. And cow, which has got by its nature tendency to eat grass, they stop chewing grass. Calf, it has got natural tendency to drink milk from the udder of her mother, his mother. He stops to engulf that milk inside his stomach. Everyone stops their natural activity just because of your melodious flute voice. So we are very
free.
Now tree, when they hear the voice, melodious voice of flute, they bend their branches down and they shower their flowers on the lotus feet of Krishna to show their love and enjoyment because they are hearing the voice of flute. Stone melts and Yamuna ji becomes a stone. They reverse their nature only by hearing the flute of melodious voice of flute.
Oh.
And your beauty. Now Maharaj is explaining about beauty more. Gopi says that even Lakshmi, our demi goddess, they are allured towards your beauty. But to speak of we. So if we are unable to resist ourselves and we are unable to remain chaste and pure as per instruction and injection of the scriptures, then the fault does not come to us. We are not to be blamed. It is your beauty and it is your melodious and sweet voice of flute which is forcing us to change our religion and to become impious. So our faults lie on us. This is a very, very wonderful and sweet description of how beautiful Krishna is.
Maharaj,
in Hindi, tell me about this.
सनातन गोस्वामी जी और एक उदाहरण दे रहे हैं कृष्ण के
So there is another verse which Sanatana Goswami is quoting here, and we have seen every single item of this universe, either inert or living, they get attracted towards Krishna's beauty. So much that they give up their intrinsic characteristic and natural qualities. But that's not enough. When Krishna himself sees his own beauty, he gets attracted. This is the top on the of everything. He gets so much attracted that how beautiful is he? When Krishna performed his Dwarka Leela and he was about to leave, so Maharaj is explaining that pastime. Krishna was sitting beneath a tree, and at that time Uddhavji came to him. Uddhavji knew that he is going and he is curtailing all the pastimes on this earth. He was very sad. Krishna gave him some instructions. And at that time, when Krishna left this abode, all demigods saw that he went with all his associates to Golok Vrindavan. Maharaj is here mentioning that his all the dynasty children and their children, apparently they died in a fighting. Apparently, just as a magician shows a magic and where he shows that he kills someone and he dies. Similarly, Krishna magician, he showed a pastime where all his dynasty, their children and their children, they fought together and died. Baladev Prabhu also left this abode and Krishna was going to leave. Then he gave instructions to Uddhavji. Uddhavji, having very sad heart, as per instructions, going to Badrinath Ashram. He was passing through Vrindavan. Just coming near to Vrindavan, he was very much attached to it. All the past memories recollected. Maharaj was saying he did not enter into Vrindavan. He kept Vrindavan on his right side as if he did parikrama of Vrindavan. And he was passing by me. Meanwhile, he met Vidurji there. And Vidur and Uddhavji, they started having discussion. Uddhav said, look, Krishna descended on this earth. It was his unlimited mercy on the earthly people, so that the people of this earth who are taking birth and death, they should get attracted towards him. To attract them towards him, to situate them in their natural position, to generate love in them for him, Krishna performed his pastime on this earth. But we could not understand. The people on this earth could not realize it. They considered him as an ordinary person, as an ordinary human being. They could not realize his exalted position. Krishna takes so many incarnations, so many. But in this particular form, where he is in the adolescent age, Kishore Avastha, Natwar, just like as a playful boy, in an adolescent age, such a beautiful form. It is not that he takes this form, it is his natural form, it is his form, it is he and his form. But we could not realize this thing. Maharaj is saying, the verse he quoted here, Uddhavji is saying, this form has such a high beauty that even Krishna gets attracted towards him. That is why Krishna wanted to enjoy his own beauty. And in order to enjoy his own beauty, he came here as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, stealing the heart of Radharani. Now Maharaj is mentioning here a very important point. Why he came to enjoy his own beauty, stealing the heart of Radharani, mood of Radharani. Because the final and ultimate beauty of Krishna can be enjoyed by Radharani only, by the mood of Radharani only. So Krishna wanted to enjoy his own beauty to the fullest extent. Therefore, he had no other way but to have mood of Radharani. So he stole the mood of Radharani. Here Maharaj is establishing one principle that if one wants to enjoy the beauty of Krishna, he should have mood of Radharani. What is mood of Radharani? That is called love. That loveful mood of Radharani is only the capacity of a person to enjoy Krishna's beauty. Kans was not having this mood at all, he could not enjoy that beauty. All those who were having, like Duryodhan and others, no love for Krishna, they could not enjoy. The real enjoyment can be attained if one adopts the mood of Radharani. To whatever extent one has love for Krishna, to that much extent only he can enjoy the mood, the beauty of Krishna. So here we should measure our extent of love for Krishna. Only to that extent we can enjoy. So Maharaj is here referring that we all have come here as Seva Kunj, most exalted place, and listening to this katha, coming from different countries, giving up your all facilities with all difficulties just to generate more love and attachment for Krishna, so that you can have more and more realization of beauty of Krishna. This is the most fortunate state. Maharaj is claiming, declaring that all those who are hearing katha very sincerely, they are the most fortunate persons of this world.
Krishna heart will be melt and give
bound to the mercy. So those who are listening this katha at the foot of Seva Kunj, because of this thing, reason, Krishna's heart will melt and they will get the mercy of Krishna. Maharaj is giving mercy of Krishna by this statement, and let's receive it. So in this pastime which Uddhava is narrating, that Krishna took butter in his right hand and he stood up, taking the help of, as the help of a pillar which was made of jewel in the house of Yashoda Nanda Baba. And he was taking round of that pillar, what you call spinning, he was taking round of that pillar, and he saw his own image in that pillar through those jewels. At that time, when he saw his own picture, his own image, he got attracted. Who is such a beautiful boy? Such an attractive boy? He got attracted. I should make friendship with him. In order to make friendship with that boy, he offers butter to him. The moment he offers butter to him, that boy also starts offering butter to him. Oh, he is very naughty. Huh?
I am offering butter to him and he is offering butter to me instead of taking it, very naughty boy. Then he became little angry. Why are you showing this naughtiness to me? The moment he became angry, that boy also became angry. When that boy became angry, then he started making some face postures. Boy also started making the same postures. Meanwhile, Yashoda Ma was seeing all this pastime. And when she saw it, she smiled. And Krishna realized that what is happening. Oh, it was my image. Krishna realized. The moment he realized that it was his image, he got ashamed. And he just, in ashamed state, he ran to the lap of Mother Yashoda and went into her lap. And Mother Yashoda also, Maharaj is now showing the mood of Yashoda. She took him in her lap, gave her breast to him, just putting her sari on him, and was so much ecstatic that tears started coming from her eyes. This is the state of those who really enjoy service of Krishna. So Maharaj is saying another important point. And she said, now another important point. How much beautiful Krishna is here mentioning. Let us see what is decoration and ornaments. In material world, we use ornaments and all beauty cosmetics to beautify ourselves. If an ugly girl is there, dark complexions, teeth coming out, outside, and eyes are also not good, and someone is coming to see her for many purposes, then what will happen? She will beautify herself with lot of makeup and everything. Every ugliness she will try to hide through the beautification and cosmetics. But how much time it will, how long will it last? Only for little while, and again her ugliness will come. So the ornaments and cosmetics are used here to cover our ugliness and makeup to show ourselves beautiful for some time. But in Krishna's realm that it is different. He is ornaments of ornaments. He, when ornaments are on him, they don't beautify Krishna, rather they get beautified. Maharaj is explaining a wonderful thing. Krishna is wearing kundal. That's called earring. Huh? He is wearing kundal. When he moves, then those kundals swing. So those kundals are not beautifying Krishna. Rather, they are being beautified because they get such an honor that they are hanging around the ear of Krishna. So Maharaj is putting here one point. It is Baldev Prabhu. This kundal is nothing but Baldev Prabhu. Baldev Prabhu in the form of kundal is getting an opportunity to kiss Krishna's cheeks and enjoy this pastime. So, when Mother Yashoda calms Krishna and puts feather of peacock on his hair, he looks very beautiful. And he starts playing with his friend. Then gradually what happens? That his hair starts coming. They get pendant and they are falling on his cheeks, and by this then he becomes more beautiful. When he was having tight hair, he was beautiful. But when his hairs are loose, he became more beautiful. Maharaj is explaining another time when Krishna is coming. After raising the cow, then the dust from the feet of cow is... Not feet. It comes and he, like water, is smearing on the face and hair of Krishna. And Krishna is becoming more beautiful. Anything, any ornament which is used for Krishna is not to beautify him, but that ornament gets beautified. Such as beauty is of Krishna. Therefore, Krishna, in order to enjoy his own beauty, took form of Chaitanya, came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. How beautiful will be Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself? When, in order to enjoy Krishna's beauty, having mood of Radharani and complexion of Radharani, when he came here, how much benevolent and beautiful he will be. So Maharaj is praying at the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that to such Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who has come with such an idea and such a desire, we should go and our obeisances so that he should bestow his mercy on us.
ये कहाँ मिला गोकुल ले गोकुल के अतिरिक्त ब्रजमंडल गोकुल कहो ब्रज कहो ये सुनो संताओ ये संतेक्षम महाप्रसाद लिटल एंड दैट वी विल गो टू ऑल दिस गो आई विल आल्सो गो टू दर्शन एंड प्रतिमा ऑफ राधा दाम एंड Shanti. And that you will return very soon. And if I will have time, that I will see anywhere, and all the devotees who can speak with me, they can come and hear me. If any question or anything, all can come. Shanti. Kaiju. Das Sri Gaurav. In what is Maharaj Sankar? Tomorrow we will lift Vrindavan and we will go first to Handivan, Bhadravan, Handivan, Mansarovar, then from Andhagar, Gokul, Mahavan, Rahul, Nathapur, and Lokavan we will go. So you have to take your all luggage there. You can do that. Some, they can keep there any room. And which is, though it is not, not so much cold, but if maybe that man will reach in Govardhan and after Annapur, at once, cold will come, it is night summer. But very soon, at once it may come cold. So you should take something for him.
Thank you. They should not
find themselves new with these words. Like Kunj, everywhere you would find this word will be used. And I don't think that every time it is required that we should translate its meaning, grove or garden. Like Kunj. Kunj is a place where Radha Krishna, they perform their pastimes. And Maharaj also told very nicely, it is created by Vrinda. Ground is very beautiful and it is covered by trees and creepers. Such nice that even sunlight does not come inside. Heavily lantern by trees and creepers. Well, then Deep Goswami said that you should broom. Sweep this Kunj every day. And he was doing this thing.
Ow.
A Kunj at the bank of Yamuna, there was no any name of this one. This Jharu Mandal name is now, not at that time. It was a Kunj. Maharaj Aage, chalo ji Maharaj Aage, let's go there. Maharaj is here now at Radha Sohan.
Thank you.
यहाँ पर जी गोस्वामी भजन करते थे, जी गोस्वामी और कृष्णदास गोस्वामी यहीं पर भजन करते थे, और पीछे इनके अप्रतिदा में प्रवेश के पश्चात में यहाँ पर इनकी समाधि हुई। समाधि माने ये भगवान के स्वरूप जैसे ही अब नित्य लीला में प्रविष्ट करके वहाँ पर सेवा कर रहे हैं, इसलिए यहाँ पर उनको दंडवत प्रणाम करें। वी हैव कम टू द भजन स्थली ऑफ श्री जी गोस्वामी एंड श्री लक्ष्मीदास रविराज गोस्वामी। At first, Swarup Goswami is doing bhajan here, we will go there. And in his guidance, Ji Goswami, and in his guidance, and Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, in their guidances, Vishwadas Kaviraj Goswami. Here he wrote so many books, also in Radha Kunda also. Now he is in Samadhi in these places. So we bow down here and do pranam and ask for his mercy. And then we will go to Paikal. We will go to Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Chakra. And then in the last we will go to Srila Prabhupada Goswami Bhajan Puti and Samadhi and Bhugar Goswami. Gaur Pramana. Adi Vaiyo! এখানেতে শ্রীল প্রভুপাদ পদ্মে পুষ্প সমাধি এখানেতে করা হয়েছে। হিয়ার দি পুষ্পাবর সমাধি অফ শ্রীল প্রভুপাদ ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী, হি অলওয়েজ ইন দি গাইডেন্স অফ শ্রীল রূপ গোস্বামী রূপ মঞ্জরি, হি হ্যাজ প্রেড এভরিওয়ার, সো হি অলওয়েজ under the shade of Rupa Goswami, he is here. So, we should do pranam here, and then we should go proceed further.